Well, here we are back again, Jam 316, our second hour. Usually we get into discussions that have to do with your family. And today being, it's Wednesday. Today being Wednesday, I have a discussion that I think will benefit you, especially if you're into business. But before we get into that, what kind of weather are we expecting today? Today it's going to be partly cloudy in Nairobi. We are looking at highs of about 26, lows of about 15. My good people in Mombasa, look out for some sunny weather today. Slight chance of rain, but mainly good weather. 32 degrees is the high, lows of about 24. My good people in Nakuru, partly sunny skies today, highs of about 26. And then for those of us in Kisumu, you will also be experiencing a sunny day today. We are looking at highs of 29 degrees and lows of 19. That's the kind of weather that you are experiencing today. But as I always say, the best thing is carry your weather wherever you go. So my question for the day, as we set the agenda for our discussion this hour, what kind of discipline do you think it takes to sustain a business? What kind of discipline do you think it takes to sustain a business? Your answers via SMS on 20316, WhatsApp 0786316316. Send in those thoughts and answers and we'll take a look at them and we'll see how that goes even as we get into our discussion for today's financial clinic today. We'll be getting into a discussion of how to balance and how to plan your finances as a businessman, as a businesswoman. But before we get into that, we want to take a look at the local dailies. My guest for today, Steve G, how are you doing? It is good to have you. I haven't seen you this year. Karibu sana.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Even though we're in February, yeah. Happy New Year. Do you take coffee?
Yes, I do.
Okay, how many sugars?
Two, please.
I don't know, well, how did you receive the news that former President Daniel Moi died yesterday? Where were you? How did you receive the news?
I dropped my son in school in the morning, and I found some people listening to a radio.
Okay.
And they were listening to Moi's speeches from back in the day. At that point, I had not heard of the news.
Okay.
So I'm asking them, what's going on? They say, yeah, you know, we went to school, and they talked about Maziwa Anyao, which was memorable. Then after that, I went for a meeting with a friend. Mm-hmm. And when we were having the breakfast meeting is when I saw on TV that Moi is dead.
Yes.
And I think it was shocking.
Yes.
Yeah. And spent most of the day just trying to process. And you know, for those of us who grew up in the 70s, 80s,
yes,
what we were seeing in news is not history.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually what we lived through.
Exactly.
And that was how I spent most of yesterday.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at the local dailies. Mm-hmm. Daily Nation, I love how it looks today. If my cameraman can zoom in on it. The big story is the last imperial president. I like the black and white look, the black and white picture of, the late former president. It says, good man, dirty game. He was not perfect. Neither was he modern in his practice of politics, appreciation of human rights, and the finer points of economic management. But he was a good nationalist, humble and compassionate. Moi was also a Willie Ruthless self-styled professor of politics who wore power like a tailor-made suit, striding across the corridors of state with a self-assurance at variance with his modest beginnings in Kuriengwo village, Baringo County. Yeah. The people who write these headlines must have passed. Who knew the jama alikuwa anapata 100 kwa English? Unasikia hiyo kizungu?
Na geography.
Because of this name.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts? You know, I was having a discussion with Pastor James Mine in the previous hour.
Yeah.
One of the things that really disturbed me yesterday is going on social media and seeing believers, friends, people I know personally, and they really didn't have anything good to say about former President Moi. You know, and they were saying how we pretend that everybody is good once they die. Mm-hmm. And I really struggled with that.
Yeah.
What memories do you have?
I think, same thing. When I got to hear the news, my friend spent some time on, because she's in media.
Yeah.
She spent some time on Twitter, and I got to see a bit of what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
And it was disappointing.
Mm.
Yeah. A thought that came to mind is just a verse that comes in moments like this.
Yeah.
And it's, let he who has no sin cast the first stone.
That's exactly what Pastor shared.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And True. There were, like all of us, Moi had his dark sides. Mm-hmm. He had his, on a political level, some of the conversations that people talk about are true.
Yeah.
But then the one thing we forget is that across the region, Kenyans remained like a beacon mm-hmm. of light, which is one of the blessings and that God has given us
yeah.
through since independence.
Yes.
And he held us together.
Yeah.
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 Up until, I think, 92, when we got into multi-party mm-hmm. politics. Mm-hmm. And after that, then the political space changed.
Yes.
What I remember about him is his humbleness. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I got to see him. I didn't interact with him at any point.
Yeah.
But I got to see him in a few occasions.
Okay.
I was talking with my daughter yesterday and saying I was there when Section 2A was repealed. I was uh-huh. in Kasarani
yeah.
on that day. Uh-huh. Yeah. I was there when he handed over to Kibaki
yes.
At Uhuru Park. Yeah. There's a day when I was at the university. I went for a walk around State House,
uh-huh.
and there was a group of young guys playing football at the field near State House Girls.
Yeah.
So I walked in and I stood there. Surprisingly, the guy next to me looked familiar. It was the president himself.
Next to you?
Yeah.
Wow.
You know, you find like four or five guys. Yes. He was standing there watching football. You know, that one of one team without
yeah.
T-shirts.
Yeah.
So there's a side of him and there are stories about him that we don't share.
Mm-hmm.
And like you said, the disappointing fact is that Christians were the ones who threw most of the stones
most
yesterday.
Of the stones. Yeah. 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 There's also this other story that's also equally tragic and making headlines. The stampede that happened in the school in Kakamega
yes.
and the children who died, anguish and dashed hopes as families and the nation mourn school tragedy victims. Mm-hmm. I don't know what your thoughts on this are. It's also another sad story.
Yeah, especially coming from just a few months ago when the school collapsed here in Gando, mm-hmm. in Nairobi.
Mm-hmm.
It's painful to see parents go through the loss of a child in any one moment.
Mm-hmm.
But for a situation like this, I saw in the news a lady who was crying because her child had just been in school for 3 weeks.
Oh my goodness.
So you're believing and trusting and have a dream for your children.
Yes, you've hustled for school fees.
Yes, and you picked this institution because of many conversations and such a tragedy happens.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't want to pass blame to anyone because some of the facts are not yet out.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a painful journey, and it will be a painful journey for these parents.
Yeah.
And we hope and pray, especially for the students.
Mm-hmm.
You know, with the stampede, 14 passed away, I hear close to 100 in hospital.
Yeah.
There might be a need for counseling and therapy.
Very true.
For both the children.
Mm-hmm.
There's a story that was highlighted of a child who died protecting their younger sibling.
Yes, I remember that story.
Yes. So, you know, is that, is it called survivor's guilt or survivor's
mm-hmm,
remorse?
Mm-hmm.
So there'll be, there needs to be a relevant conversation mm-hmm. in that institution.
Yeah.
But beyond that, my daughter asked me, so what do I do in case of a stampede?
Uh-huh.
Maybe there's, on a broader conversation, that whole disaster and emergency drills for schools.
Yes.
Such that there's an awareness
yes.
when there's this kind of commotion, what do you do? We need to be more proactive in protecting our children.
Yeah, and not even schools, even churches.
Churches,
you know,
and
I think, was it this week or last week, there was also the story of the stampede
yes.
in the church.
And
was it in Tanzania?
About 20 or something people died.
Yeah.
So we tend, in the rush to save ourselves, we are not aware of the things we need to do.
Yes.
And maybe this and a few other stories that have happened need to call us to attention.
Very true.
Yes.
Well, you can get a copy of the local dailies, inform yourself on some of the stories that's happening locally. A lot in the papers today is about Daniel Moi, 1924 to 2020, about his family, about his legacy, what different leaders have to say about him. And so grab a copy, keep yourself informed on what's happening locally and internationally. We are getting into our conversation for today on the Financial Clinic, talking to you, businessman, businesswoman. A lot of businesses, and I know Steve probably will give us some statistics, but quite a number of businesses don't see their first or second year. They start and they collapse, they fail. And many times I believe it's because of finances. And sometimes it's not necessarily that finances are not available or they are not enough. Managing managing your finances as a business person. That's what we're going to be looking at in the coming hour, not in the coming hour, in the coming short while. And also the question for the day, what does it take to manage a business? 20316 SMS line, WhatsApp number 0786316316. It's Wednesday, financial clinic, as I usually say, tumeweka bench hapo nje. Tumeisafisha ni safi, watu waingie mmoja mmoja tuwahudumie. Yeah, this morning we are going to be focusing on the businessmen and the businesswomen, and I hope that our conversation today will be beneficial to you. Questions are welcome. 20316 SMS line, WhatsApp number 0786-316-316. We will be focusing on your finances in your business. In studio with me today is Steve G. Steve is a certified professional coach and also works with Endeavor Connections. He works a lot with startups.
Startups and business owners.
Startups and business owners.
Yes.
Steve, karibu sana. You're the right person for this conversation.
Yes.
So a lot of businesses start, and a lot of people today are getting into business. Mm-hmm. What to a side hustle, what to a serious business. In fact, I was talking to a friend of mine yesterday, and I was saying it's interesting. When you walk into town today, every building has stalls.
Yes.
And there are people there with goods, meaning mm-hmm. biashara inaendelea. Mm-hmm. But how comes a lot of these businesses don't survive 2 years?
There's statistics out there that about 90% of businesses won't survive the first 2 years.
Yes.
And of the remaining ones, about 80 to 90% of them will not survive 5 years. So of every 10 businesses that start, probably one or two will be in existence 5 years from now.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a sad truth,
yeah.
But it's also a good fact.
Good? What do you mean? What's, what's so good about the morning?
One of the things we need to acknowledge and appreciate is that doing business is hard,
okay.
Yeah, generally.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But then there's a conversation we had. I was having with a friend of mine, and there's a question of how is your business evolving? So those who failed in the first 2 years,
mm-hmm.
5 years later, they're still in business.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're just doing something new. The attitude we've developed probably for us as Kenyans is that when you fail, you consider yourself failed,
yeah.
And then you try again. And there's a culture that we need, I hope we can develop, where when you fail,
mm.
you consider yourself learned.
Oh, big difference.
That whatever challenges you went through,
yeah.
become a learning process,
okay.
that then help you in your new season.
Mm-hmm.
So businesses evolve. If you study the world wide, one of the questions we used to ask is, a business like Nokia,
yeah.
the telephone.
Yes.
They started in the wood industry. At some point, they were doing rubber.
Mm-hmm.
So businesses evolving over time
mm.
is a good thing.
Okay.
The challenge is whether or not we are learning. Yeah. So why do they fail in those first 2 years? I think it's just we get our fundamentals wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Like you mentioned, for purposes of this conversation today, financial management is one of the biggest hurdles,
okay.
challenges.
Yeah.
Most of us don't know how our businesses are doing.
Oh.
Yes. So there's a statement I saw last week, and it says 93% of business owners are running blind.
That's a very interesting statement, because you would assume that, I go to my business, and clients are coming in, they are paying for the goods or for the services, a transaction happens, it's been a good day, I go home, I come back tomorrow, I do it again.
Yes. But that is not doing business.
Oh,
yeah.
What is that?
That is just, let me just call it day in, day out.
Uh-huh.
We've just begun February.
Yes.
And in my space, as I've been working with business owners, one question I've been asking them was, how was 2019?
Mm-hmm.
And most of them say it was a good year, or it was a bad year.
Yeah.
Then I ask them, what makes it a good, or what makes it a bad year?
Yeah.
We don't have any statistics to back up our conversations as business owners.
Okay.
So if you sit down and say 2019 was a good year because I made money,
mm-hmm.
so how much did you make? Yeah. Did you actually make money, or do you just have a surplus because you haven't finished paying on your debts for last year?
Mm.
Yeah. Are you making profit, or are you making revenue? So what you're talking about, you go in day in, day
yeah,
out,
yeah.
we are looking at revenue. Because
okay.
there's money coming in, money going out,
yes.
we assume the business is doing well. But on the other side, the question should be, are you actually making profit per transaction?
Mm-hmm.
Are you making profit per customer?
Yes.
Are you spending more to acquire a customer than they're paying you for their service?
Are those things a lot of businesses fail to think about?
We don't know about them.
Oh, we don't even know about them.
We don't even know about them.
You know, was it last week? Last week I was having a very interesting conversation with Waidhaka, CEO of Centonomy.
Yes.
And he was telling me that he had a conversation with entrepreneurs, and he was asking them, so how do you make money in your business?
Yeah.
And he said over 90% could not answer that question correctly. And I thought that is strange.
Yes.
How? But they're in business.
So we think.
Oh.
I think there's this, you know, there are words we throw out there that I'm a business owner.
Yeah.
Or I'm an entrepreneur.
Yes.
But when you sit down and look at the fundamentals, what you're doing is you're just a funnel of money coming in and going out.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the day, there's no... you don't have anything left.
Okay.
So your business is not going to grow,
mm-hmm.
for one. You're not going to be stable at any one point. And the fact that there's money coming in, if you look at your bank statement,
yeah.
there was money through the system,
mm-hmm.
but there was no money in the business.
Mm.
So like now, like I was saying...
It's like the way when I look at my M-Pesa statements and I realize 2 million passed through my M-Pesa and I have nothing in my pocket.
Yes. So like now, there's what I was saying about customer acquisition.
Yes.
Maybe if you don't know, it might be costing you about 6,000-7,000 shillings to mm-hmm. acquire a customer mm-hmm. who's paying you 4,000 shillings.
Mm-hmm.
So that customer is a loss from the beginning.
Because
it's costing you more to get them
yeah.
and get their business than you're making from them. But since we don't know how much money you're spending.
Yes.
Yeah. To acquire a customer, what I'm saying, cost of customer acquisition.
Yes.
Then you don't know. Yeah, there was money.
So where is the gap? If so many businesses are having all these struggles,
mm-hmm.
you know, you said about 90% of them don't finish their first 2 years.
Yes.
So you have so many people who have the passion, have the desire to get into business,
mm-hmm.
but they're not succeeding. Where is the gap? Which gap do we need to fill?
I'd like to say, let me call it a knowledge gap.
Okay.
Yeah. And what's happening is that there are forums out here that are teaching people on how to do business.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there are organizations that are preparing for that. But few of us as business owners want to invest in learning on how to do business. Like for us at Endeavor, what we do is we sit down with the business owner and help them think and structure their year
mm-hmm.
and then create critical indicators that you can track through that year.
Okay.
And our biggest indicator is not necessarily financial.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So there's something we call a growth audit. There's opportunities to learn. But as business owners, I think you invest in everything else apart from yourself.
Okay.
And your capacity
yeah.
to run the business.
Yeah.
When you think of it, most of us who say we are entrepreneurs, one of the questions we've asked in our sessions is who's an entrepreneur?
Mm-hmm.
And when we have a conversation, majority actually turn out not to be. There's an entrepreneur,
uh-huh.
there's a business owner,
yes.
and then there's somebody who's self-employed.
Mm.
The person who's self-employed is the one we talk about as a business owner.
Okay.
What you did is you fired your boss, started something called yourself CEO,
yeah.
and you're treating yourself worse than you are being treated where you're employed. Yeah. And when you look at the most organizations, like it's beginning of year again.
Yes.
Let me call them bigger organizations. We'll have a strategy retreat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Yeah,
definitely.
And
definitely.
Call a board meeting
yeah.
where the board will sit down and say, what are we doing this year? Yeah. What do you do as solopreneurs when you're working alone?
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever call yourself
a strategy
meeting? When you go for a strategy meeting, who's backing you up?
In fact, we even have a strategy meeting. We go for holidays in December.
Yeah.
Say it's been a good year.
Yeah.
Or tunaambia mwili pole.
Yeah.
We come back in January and we hit the road and we do it all over again.
And we pray.
Yeah.
And hope that God will answer prayers.
We fast and pray.
Yes. It's a good day.
What would you say are the common financial mistakes people make in business?
Let me say the biggest one.
Yeah.
Is most business owners don't have records.
Oh.
Yeah. You remember that standard book called a cash book?
Yeah.
So you don't know money coming in and money going out.
I hated that book.
When I went to high school, I did business education. You remember that?
Yes.
That course?
Yes.
And I dropped it in Form 1 because mm-hmm. it didn't make sense. But then when I finished high school, I went and did my CPAs. And here I am now working with business owners.
Imagine.
Yeah. So the fundamental cash book, where is your money coming in? Where is your money going?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We don't have that record. Secondly, we don't have, let me call it a budget or in terms of a projection. Okay. So there's no idea, you don't have a clear plan of what you need to do this year, mm-hmm. which then advises everything else that you're doing. When you think of cash flow, money becomes like the oxygen of your business.
Very true.
Yeah? Your cash flow becomes like the blood that sustains your business. Mm-hmm. But yet we're not investing in, if you don't know your money going out,
yeah.
you don't even know your stock records.
Mm.
So if I came to your business and ask, what stock do you currently have? Most people say,
give me a minute.
Yes.
Yeah.
If I ask you, how much money did you make last month in January?
Mm-hmm.
It's not top of mind.
Yeah.
Is this quarter going to be any better than last year, same quarter? We don't know.
We're just hoping.
Yes. So I'd say the biggest challenge is that we don't keep track of our money.
Mm-hmm.
And then since we don't know where our money is coming in and going out, we don't even have an idea of whether or not we're adding value to our customers.
Okay. Yeah. Do these things matter because a business is big, or do they matter from the get-go, even if your business is just tiny?
Let me put it this way. When you go to a supermarket,
uh-huh.
yeah, and you get your receipt,
yes,
it gives you, this is what you've bought. The system then tells the organization, mm. the financial department, these things have been bought and have moved. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So there's an idea of what's remaining in stock. Mm-hmm. Then every so often they do a stock take to verify.
Yeah.
There's an idea of what has come and where it has come from.
Mm.
That, when you're doing our trainings, anomalies, even somebody like a mama mboga,
yeah.
she needs her records.
Oh.
Yeah? Anybody in between.
Yes.
I'm using mama mboga because we talk of micro businesses.
Yes.
We do training for micro business on one of our arms, and we ask if the supermarket needs to keep records,
mm.
what records does the mama boga have?
Mm-hmm.
What record does the consultant have? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not about size. It's about, the fundamentals are the same regardless of scale.
Okay.
It's just that how you do them in the different, how depends on how big your business is.
Mm.
But just to sum that up, most of us don't have records and we don't know how our business is doing. We're running blind.
It's just one day at a time. Leo ya kuuza, iko umeuza, tomorrow will take care of itself. Do you have any questions in regards to your finances where your business is concerned? You're having challenges, maybe managing your finances in your business. Mara pesa iko, mara haiko. Sometimes you have no idea how things are going to turn out. Talk to us, 20316 SMS9, WhatsApp number 0786-316-316. I have another guest I'll be introducing him to us in the next short while, as he also shares his personal experience, some of the challenges he went through in the early years of his business, and how he was able to go through that, learn some lessons, and where he is today.
Kwanza mtu wa biashara lazima awe na discipline. Discipline kumaanisha kusema mtu akiuliza kitu ajibu kwa njia inayofaa, kwa mafaa, kwa njia ya taratibu na hekima na busara. Na tena ya pili, mtu wa biashara lazima uwe na maarifa mingi, kujua biashara vitu natoka bei rahisi, nauza pande hii, natoka pande hii na pande huo. Discipline ni kuwa hekima, busara, yani discipline yake lazima uwe na kuongea na watu kwa njia inayofaa. Hiyo ni discipline moja. Ya pili, akipata pesa ziende kwa malaya, ama kwenda kwa gharibu kwa club ama wapi.
Tunafaa kuelewa na kujiuliza ni what exactly do I want in this business? Do I want to keep customers, or I want a one-off? They buy and go. Because if that is what you want, you'll treat them like trash. But if you want ile ni tangwa unataka wao wanakuja tu all the time, you'll treat them with respect. Yeah. Respect is paramount in business and in everything.
Perseverance in terms of customers. There are times when customers won't turn up even for days or for months. You have to persevere, don't give up. And then also, same when it comes to discipline, I'm a perseverance. Eh? There are customers who behave differently. There are some who will come and abuse you. There are some who will give you names, but just persevere. So I think perseverance should be the first discipline.
I'll go for discipline, both discipline and patience. Because it takes patience, and for you to be patient, you must be disciplined.
It is the Jam 316 Financial Clinic. This happens every Wednesday on Family Radio 316 and on Family TV. Simultaneously, we are looking at the whole issue of how to manage and to handle your finances in business and inviting your questions as well. 20316 is the SMS line. WhatsApp number is 0786-316-316. Even as we continue with this discussion, I'm just looking at some traffic updates that are coming via social media platforms and all that. Mombasa Road, Syokimau area, Airport Junction is a total mess. It's bumper to bumper all the way. Hardly any movement, slow movement on Langata Road as well. Traffic on Langata Road is beginning at Bomas, slowly trickling towards the city center. And then my good people also on Thika Road are having quite a hard time. It's also bumper to bumper on Thika Road. My second guest for us today is here with us, Jerry Oliech, co-founder Legacy Car Rentals. How are you doing?
Very well.
It is good to have you on my show, my friend.
Thank you, sir.
It's been a while.
Too long.
So you're talking about managing your finances in business.
That's right.
Tell us your story. Tell us your story regarding this conversations when you co-founded this company, Legacy Car Rentals. How are you guys handling things? What did you learn?
Legacy started out of passion. I'm very passionate about vehicles. I love vehicles. I mean, yes. I can give you the ins and outs about a vehicle.
Yes.
I remember I had my first accident with a vehicle. I think I was about 5 or 6. My mother left me in the vehicle.
And you're one of those.
And I literally put the handbrake down and we literally glided down to the wall.
Mm-hmm.
So here I am, finished school, had this passion about vehicles, got into car rentals.
Yeah.
Brought up the business with passion,
mm-hmm.
and had no fundamental systems on how to run the business.
Oh.
All I had was a passion of how I could sell excellent service to you as an individual or as an organization.
Mm-hmm.
And then the backdrop, like Mr. Steve was saying, you've got nothing that is checking your ins, your outs, or even your profitability.
Mm-hmm.
So you finish a quarter, you finish a whole annual takeover, and you've seen what has gone through, but you have nothing at hand. Through that now, fundamental issues like contracts,
mm-hmm.
I had no idea about that. I mean, I would go and sit in an organization, I would turn to the page of sign here, and I would sign.
You'd sign without reading the whole thing.
I mean, you're this is Family FM. You guys just need vehicles. Let me get you the vehicles.
Yes,
I'll sign here. You need my bank account details, they're there. And it just caught up with me very harshly.
What would you say are some of the key financial mistakes you made in your earlier years?
The biggest mistake people do in business,
mm-hmm.
is not having a differentiation between your personal account as Gerald Bay Oliech, and your account of the business as Legacy Car Rentals Limited.
Break that down for us further, because I think this is interesting.
The problem is, here you are, Legacy Car Rentals has received money out of Family FM. You guys have given us good business and everything.
Yeah.
But how is Gerald getting paid?
Mm.
Is the money that's at Legacy Gerald's or is it Legacy's? So, literally for me, I mean, Legacy is me, and Gerald
Pesa
is...
Pesa imeingia,
sini yangu.
Kakunyo kahawa.
The debt I am in right now since 2011,
uh-huh.
to now that I'm still literally paying for,
uh-huh.
is because of that lack of fundamentalism, knowing that, you know what, the company is an organism, or a baby, or an organization on its own.
On its own, yeah.
And you, as either the co-founder, the director, whatever you are, whatever position you hold in it, mm-hmm. you need to get paid. If I go out and market, I am marketing not Gerald.
Mm-hmm.
I am marketing my company.
Yes.
So being my company or being a director just shows that I am trying to push this company forward. In other words, the company should go to a place whereby it should work without me.
Mm-hmm.
I should be literally either working for the company, right, not being on the company fully sitting, like literally sitting on this chair.
Yeah.
If I come out of this chair is empty. So if Gerald was to leave today, what would Legacy Car Rentals be?
Mm-hmm.
So that's a mistake people make. So the money comes into the account, it's my money.
It's my money, yeah.
I mean, I
biashara ni yangu. Mimi ndio nimefanya kazi, pesa ni yangu.
Can buy the latest phone.
Yes.
Get the shoes, the colognes.
So that's
good.
A mistake.
That's a very big mistake. Because if this, I mean, like Steve said earlier,
mm-hmm.
people leave their current employment and go and treat themselves in much worse than where they're working.
Yes.
And it's because of this simple thing. You are not managing what is coming into the business mm-hmm. versus what should come to you. I mean, you should be realistically put yourself in a place that if the company didn't make enough money to pay you,
yeah.
why are you not getting paid? Is it your pricing?
Mm.
Do you even have a good profit margin to know what profit margin you should be getting?
So are you saying that if I leave work, mm. now I've left Family Media, I've gone out there,
yeah.
I'm starting my own outfit,
yeah.
is it wise to put myself on a salary? Is that what you're saying?
You need to. I mean, if you left your current employment, how are yeah. you going to pay your rent? How are you going to pay school fees? How are you going
to... Biashara ikiingiza pesa, inalipa pia rent.
So is now, if you are the business,
yeah.
if you are the value of what you're selling, James Okumu presenter, James Okumu MC,
mm-hmm.
that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
But when you have a company that you set up, I hope we also know that by the time you set up a company, 30% of that company is owned by the government.
Mm-hmm.
So how you manage that 70%? In that 70%, are you managing your costs? Are you managing your take homes? Are you managing your marketing? Are you managing
yes.
anything like your telecom? I mean, the reason I'm on postpaid is because my company can pay for it.
Yes.
I can't be talking with a client on a fundamental issue about a breakdown and...
Bamba 50, Meisha.
You know, so is my company making enough money for me to handle my communication?
Uh-huh.
Is my company making enough money to sustain me to do the kind of jobs I'm doing?
Yes.
And one thing I learned that I try and bring out to people I equip and empower
mm.
is that how do you price yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Basically, you should be in a place whereby you look at what's costing you to make this business, factor in your profit, then give the client the price.
Now, that's a very interesting thing you're saying. The other day, my wife had gone for this meeting.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she once in a while goes for this meeting mm-hmm. with caterers.
Mm-hmm.
And the other day, she came from a meeting. They were being taught about pricing.
Exactly.
And she came home and she was telling me, wow, 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 wow. Me, I've been undercharging people on all these things.
Uh-huh.
Since we were taught how to price these things, man, I need more education.
Exactly.
Would you say... A lot of people who are in business don't understand how to price. You just put a figure to it. I bought it at 5 bob, I'll sell it at 10 bob.
Exactly.
But they don't know why they're selling it at 10 bob.
Exactly. Because you see, let's be realistic.
Uh-huh.
Passion can get you business because I'll sell it so well.
Yes, you know you.
I'll sell it so well,
yeah.
you'll come because, you know what, I trust Jerry, or I trust, you know what?
Mm-hmm.
By the time you're looking at the backdrop of legacy, you've mm-hmm. already trusted Jerry, so you're giving Jerry the business.
Yes.
Now, the realistic thing about it, passion will not pay your bills.
Mm-hmm.
Passion will not take your kids to school. Passion will not pay your debt or
yes.
whatever you have. So that's the biggest mistake I made.
Mm-hmm.
So, and part of the place in where I am in business is that I sub-hire.
Uh-huh.
So I would come and sub-hire from GMO to give it to Steve,
mm.
but I've not priced the thing well. So eventually when the money comes into the company, I'm
yeah.
thinking, my goodness, all this money is going to go to GMO and there's nothing going to remain on myself.
Yes.
So, and I'm sorry to say this, guys end up undercutting now your sub.
Uh-huh.
Because now I'm thinking, I'm supposed to pay GMO 12, let me pay him 8.
Yes.
And then I'll wait for the next cycle. That cycle doesn't come. Economy has changed.
Yes.
And I try and challenge people, you know what? Know your market before
mm-hmm.
you give a price. What's your competition? And you're not knowing your competition to go and compete with them.
No.
You have your target, so know the competitive rate and then price according to that. Knowing your costs and then valuing your profit.
Okay.
If you have a profit margin of 50, make sure that 50 is within the cost.
Mm-hmm.
If it's 100, the same. So if you're going to give it out, you know your cost is 50,
yeah.
your profit is 100, so you start giving your pricing between 200 and 150. Don't go below that. If you go below that, who's going to hurt? Not the client, because they'll pay.
Yes. Wow. I hope you're learning something this morning. Your questions are welcome. I have one question here that we'll be getting into shortly. Somebody's saying that their business is struggling to break even because they have so much debt. The little that they make is going into repaying the debt. They're wondering how can they get out of that cycle. We have a couple of minutes remaining, and so if you have a question to send in, please send it in now. 20316 is the SMS line. WhatsApp number 0786-316-316. Shortly, we'll get to hear from Steve again and Jerry. Solutions. So how do we move out from this cycle and get into the space where our businesses are thriving and growing. It is the Financial Clinic. We are talking about managing the finances in your business. Questions are coming in on 20316, WhatsApp on 0786-316-316. Steve and Jerry are in studio with us today. I have a very interesting question here. This one says, hi family, niko na biashara ya cafe. Like my new business here. Yeah? She says last year was a very challenging year due to the fact that I had no records. I came to realize that my family was draining my business by food expenditure. My question is, how do I keep records consistently and how do I expand the business? Because I feel I'm really working hard and pushing myself in the process. It's been 6 years now, but I'm crawling at a snail's speed and imebidi nipunguze workers. It's now just one worker and myself that are remaining. Yeah.
Let me, for this question and for most of us in business, mm-hmm. we can start by just basic records, yeah, mm-hmm. which is an exercise book with two columns.
Yes.
Where you say, I have sold 100 shillings.
Yes.
I have bought something, 20 shillings. Then at the end of the day, how much money did I sell? Mm-hmm. How much money did I spend? What's left? And does it show in the account? Yeah. Mm-hmm. So the book and what I have in the till, in the cash box, balance off.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's a basic start even for this person. Okay. Then secondly, after that is we need to, like Gerard was saying, we need to separate ourselves from the business. Mm. There is the business and then there's me.
Okay. So I'm not the business.
You're not the business.
You're a marketer.
Yeah. You're an employee.
I'm a marketer in my business.
Yes. You're an employee mm-hmm. in the business.
Okay.
So, like I think he mentioned earlier, most of us, I was earning 30,000 when I was employed.
Yes.
So when I step out, I want the business to pay me 30,000.
Yeah.
But when we do our cash book, the balance that is left is 25,000, which we normally call profit. Mm. Then I take all that 25,000.
Yeah.
Then it means the business is not making a profit because you've taken everything. And as an employee, you're an expense.
Take me slowly.
Yeah. Okay, so let's start by the
because
business.
My assumption is the business has made a profit, and since I'm the owner of the business, I've paid myself with a profit, so we're profitable.
So put it this way.
Jerry
and that's where most of us are. Yes. I've been there, Gerald has been there.
That's a lie.
So think of it this way.
That's a lie.
Profit is whatever money is left in the business after all expenses have been paid.
Including
your salary.
Profit remains in the business.
Yes.
It doesn't go into my pocket. I'm the business owner.
No, if it goes into your pocket,
yeah.
then you are stealing.
Thank you.
From your business. So when the business fails, it uh-huh. was not the harsh economy times.
Uh-huh.
It was not customers or it was not customers not paying.
Yes.
Is that we as business owners have been stealing mm-hmm. From our businesses, which is why they are collapsing.
Yeah.
So for this one, this question, and most of us in business,
yeah.
start with a basic cash book.
Okay.
Money in, money out.
Yeah.
And a basic stock book.
Mm-hmm.
What do I have in stock? Mm-hmm. And then separate yourself from the business.
In fact, my challenge to them would be,
yeah.
And I don't want to say it so harshly that it sounds like they're not in business. I think for them, there's a mode of which they've been paid,
mm-hmm.
whether it's cash, M-Pesa,
yeah.
or even to whatever they do deposit. In fact, like you said, your M-Pesa is as good as a bank transaction.
Yeah.
So I think she has or he has basic records. They just don't know it yet.
Yes.
Ah.
And those are the fundamentals that Steve is talking about. There's no way, even a mama mboga, you pay them by M-Pesa.
Yeah.
Everyone has, okay, not everyone, but guys have Lipa and M-Pesa, pay bill.
Yes.
So when it comes to records, we're not in, I mean, like the days we used to do business in Moi's time, I could believe you don't have records. But right now there's M-Pesa.
Wow.
There's M-Sure,
yes.
there's what? I mean, you already have records, you just don't know what you have.
I'm hearing voices. And you know when I hear voices, things need to move. Yeah. Voices in my head. We are actually out of time, but this conversation needs to go on, so we'll take it up to the radio studio
sure.
and continue with this. We have to cut it short for TV for right now because our time for TV is up, but we are continuing with this discussion on radio. So hook up with us on radio if you are not tuned in on radio as we continue with this discussion. So if you still have more questions, send them in. 20316 SMS line, WhatsApp number 0786-316-316. That's all the time we have. Our TV viewers, thank you so much. Hook up with us. Hey!
We appreciate this.
Tongue twister. Hook up with us tomorrow, same time, same station, as we have more discussions that I believe will benefit you. Have a great morning.